Universal Design for Learning is a framework that offers guidelines for developing flexible learning environments to accommodate all the different learning styles and pedagogical needs of students. Defined by David Rode in the 1990s, it draws heavily on Ronald Mace's Universal Design in Architecture, prescribing designing products and environments usable by all people to the greatest extent possible without need for significant adaptation. Simply, design items so that most people can use them with minimal effort. The theory also draws heavily on cognitive learning theories promoted by the work of both Vygotsky and Bloom. There are three principles to universal design for learning. Principle 1, provide multiple means of representation. Providing multiple means of representation gives learners various ways of acquiring information and knowledge. This encourages offering learners a variety of presentation forms so that they can select the means of representation that best suits their learning style. For example, instead of offering a video, be sure to offer closed caption or transcript with that video. Likewise, perhaps a visual illustration may accompany text to better explain the concept for visual learners. Remember, there is no one means of representation that will be optimal for all learners. Providing options for representation is essential. Principle 2. Provide multiple means for action and expression. Learners differ in the ways they can navigate a learning environment and express what they know. Effective learning environments provide learners with alternatives for demonstrating what they know. There is never one means of expression that is optimal for all learners. Some may like oral discussion, while others prefer writing papers. Providing options for action is essential for promoting learning for everyone. Principle 3. Provide multiple means of engagement. Effective learning environments tap into learners' interests, challenge them appropriately, and motivate them to learn. By challenging the students and recruiting their interests, the course will help sustain their effort and persistence. Allowing options and offering multiple means of engagement affords students the option to self-regulate their learning and choose the methods that work best for them. How does this affect you and your teaching? You should consider developing your courses, online and in the classroom, such that students have options for accessing the content they need to know. Video should have closed captions, and you should consider accompanying text with other presentations of content. Further, when designing assignments and areas for engagement, such as online discussion section, you should consider offering students a variety of options for engagement as well as how they can express themselves when doing so. When considering ADA compliance, we should see it as another reason why multiple modes of presentation are important. Not only will you help students with a recognized disability, but you may be helping others. With 1 in 20 students being dyslexic, and a disproportionate number of students with disabilities taking online classes to avoid perceived awkwardness when in a classroom, there may be a lot more students benefiting from your adoption of universal design principles than you thought. Moreover, you may also benefit other students who do not have disabilities, but prefer a different learning representation or means of engagement than was otherwise offered.